Welcome to this Slumberland sleep story. I'll be your guide as you trek through a forest just as it begins to rain. You find sanctuary in a cabin in the forest. Relax and dry off in front of a log fire. Before observing the rain for a while through the window, and then relaxing and drifting peacefully asleep. And I would like to take this moment to wish you the most peaceful night's sleep and pleasant dreams as you fall asleep to this sleep story. Before we begin the story, you can take a few moments to settle down comfortably. You can shift about a little if you need to make yourself more comfortable. And when you're ready, you can let your eyes gently close. And as the story unfolds, you can take a few deep, relaxing breaths, allowing the out-breaths to be a little longer than the in-breaths. This triggers the body's natural relaxation response. And as you relax, you can find yourself walking through a forest. And as you gently walk through this nighttime forest, you can hear the first sounds of rain as that rain begins to fall on the leaves of the trees around you. And some of that rain gradually finds its way through the canopy and down to where you are as you continue to walk through this forest. And while you walk through this forest, hearing that rain hitting the leaves overhead and all around you in all directions, the occasional drip of water that makes its way through the canopy, you push through those trees, and as you do, you can feel the damp bark beneath your hands, the texture of that bark of those trees, the feeling of each footstep that you take on the ground, as you step over some fallen down trunks, navigate over roots crossing your path, hearing the gentle sound of each footstep as you go. Just seeing the faintest of glow within this forest as you light your way with a torch attached to your top. And occasionally you notice shadows of branches and tree trunks dancing on other branches and tree trunks as you pass them by. The sight of rain that manages to just about work its way through, just the occasional few lines of drops of water breaking through the canopy, sometimes feeling that sensation of some raindrops hitting your shoulders, or perhaps hitting your head, maybe even running down into your neck. And you continue to push on through this forest. And while you push on, you're searching for some sanctuary from this weather. You know that this rain is going to increase, and that there's a storm coming. You want to be safely indoors by then. And you're aware that there's a cabin deep in this forest. You know that the cabin is empty currently. And you know this forest like the back of your hand. You know those who live deep in this forest in different cabins, and those who just stay in their cabins from time to time. And you continue trekking through this forest. And after what seems quite a while of trekking through the forest, you come to a clearing. And in this clearing is a lake in the middle of the forest. And you know that the cabin is a little bit around this lake, just out of sight. And so you know you need to walk around the lake and then head just away from the lake shore around a patch of forest where you'll find the cabin. And as you walk out into the clearing, so you notice more of that rain soaking you through. And you feel glad that the weather is just the most comfortable temperature, so that although your clothes are getting wet, you still feel comfortable. Although at the same time, you do look forward to being able to change into some dry clothes when you reach the cabin. And while walking around the lake in this forest, you can just about notice the tops of the trees opposite against the dark sky. And that with the rain clouds hanging low in the sky overhead, they add a very slight glow overhead, almost like a slight grey-blue glow, that means that you can see the tops of the trees against the clouds in the distance. You also notice, way off in the distance, the occasional flash of light hovering in the sky, aware of that distant thunderstorm that's currently so distant that any thunder is too faint to hear here. You have this sense almost like perhaps you notice a little bit of the sound of thunder, but you can't quite make it out, because it's so distant, and the sound of the rain on the leaves of the trees makes too much noise to be able to hear that distant rumble of thunder. And now there's just the subtle added sound of some of that rain on the lake, and that is barely audible and differentiable to the sound of the rain on the slight meadow area that you're crossing, and this slight clearing in the forest, and the greater sound of the rain hitting all of the surrounding trees, bouncing off the cacophony of leaves. But what you can do is look out across the lake and see that rain striking the lake water, and the lake is calm with long and low waves just gently rolling towards the shore, barely noticeable. And so it really makes the circular patterns of the raindrops striking the water stand out. And you walk slowly past this lake, almost transfixed by the way that the rain is striking the water, having a sense that you occasionally see a dancing glow hovering above the water, and you wonder if it's fireflies dancing and avoiding the raindrops as they fall, flying above the water of the lake. And you watch that for a while you continue to walk around the outside of this lake, feeling that rain as it runs down your cheeks, drips a little bit from your hair, feeling the rain on your hands, and noticing your torchlight illuminating the rain before you, and what that looks like, that rain in the torchlight. And you continue around this lake, and in the distant shadows around the lake, in the darkness, you can just make out the faint sight of a jetty sticking out into this lake. And you know that that jetty is in line with the cabin. So you continue to walk around the lake towards that jetty. And as you approach the jetty, you can hear just the faintest hint of the sound of the rain on the wood of the jetty, still drowned out by the sound of the rain and the trees. And you look in the opposite direction to the jetty, and all you can see is darkness. But you know that there's a cabin up there, and you turn to face that direction, and your torchlight is illuminating the meadow before you. And you walk up in the direction of the cabin, and as you get closer to the cabin, and closer, so your torchlight begins to reflect off of features, initially reflecting on the windows. Then you notice beside the windows subtle hint of the word of the cabin. You continue to walk towards that cabin. And as you arrive at the cabin, you walk around the cabin initially, walking all the way around to the back of the cabin, and then back around to the front. You walk up to the front door, and all of the lights are off. And you know that there should be nobody here at this time. But you politely knock on the door anyway. And you wait a few moments. And after a few moments of waiting, with no response, you knock again just to be sure, waiting a few moments more. And then when nobody appears, you crouch down to the gnome beside the front door. You lift up that gnome, and in the base of the gnome is a little compartment. You open that compartment and find a key. You take that key and then seal the compartment and place the gnome back down on the ground. You quietly and carefully open the door, walking inside the cabin, closing that door behind you. You turn on the lights to the cabin. You can hear that rain outside. Hearing the sound of the rain on the windows of the cabin. Almost having a sense that you can hear the sound of that rain on the roof of the cabin. On the walls of the cabin, as if that rain is almost reverberating through the entire cabin. You turn off your torch. You place a backpack that you've got with you down onto the floor. You take off your jacket. You go looking around the cabin. You head to the bathroom. And you grab a towel and you dry your face, back of your neck, behind your ears. You dry your head, your hair, and your hands. And as you're drying yourself off, so you head back through to the main room of the cabin. And in the main room of the cabin, you change into some dry clothes, some comfortable, almost night-time clothes that you have with you. And attached to your backpack is a single-person tent. And as you notice your tent there, you just think to yourself, for a moment, that with this weather, you'd much rather be in this cabin than out there among the trees in that tent. You make sure that your bag is placed to one side out of the way. You make yourself some food and a drink. You can smell the smell of the wood of the inside of this cabin. And have a sense that this cabin seems to have such a comforting smell to it. You head over to the fireplace. You place some of the logs and wood shavings into that fireplace. You light that fire and watch that light dance to life. And the comfortable warmth of the fire pulse out into the room, gently warming your cheeks, your hands, bringing a deep sense of comfort and relaxation. You prod that fire just a little bit before sitting down into an armchair beside that fireplace, listening to the gentle crackling of the fire in that fireplace. Observing the dancing shadows around the walls of the furniture. And as you relax there, listening to the gently crackling fire, with the soft lights on in the room, you begin to feel a deep sense of peace and calm, while still hearing that rain on the windows outside. You eat that food and drink your drink. You almost feel a sense of being refreshed and revitalized, aware that you're much drier now. You feel so comfortable here. And over a period of time, the fire burns down a little, so that it's just comfortably bubbling along in that fireplace, giving the most warm, comforting glow. And after you've finished your food and drink, while still being aware of the sound of the rain on the window, begin to find your mind drifting and floating peacefully inside, almost as if floating into a reverie. You have a sense of relaxing your mind and body. You start to focus on the top of your head, noticing how your head is resting there, how your head is so gently supported in place, noticing the comfort in and around your head while it rests so gently there. Having a sense of the muscles around your scalp and the back of your head softening and relaxing, drawing in peace and comfort with each breath that you take. Before moving your awareness around your face, focusing on what it's like for that relaxation to spread around your face, your ears and your cheeks, perhaps with the warmth of that light from the fire. Having the muscles in these areas soften and begin to relax so deeply. Relaxing the muscles around your eyes and across your forehead. While the muscles around the side of your head and over the top of your head begin to relax deeper and deeper. Noticing how you can pay attention to fading tension, or perhaps find that tension dissolves without paying it any attention at all. And you continue to allow that relaxation to spread down around your mouth, relaxing your lips and your jaw, relaxing the muscles around the side of your neck, around to the back of your neck and around your throat, softening, relaxing deeper and deeper. And as your jaw relaxes and hangs slightly loose, limp and comfortable, that relaxation can continue to move down to your shoulders and your upper back, and I don't know whether that relaxation happens fastest around your shoulders or in the upper back or perhaps down the tops or the front of your shoulders as that relaxation progresses around your back and your chest, softening and relaxing those muscles fully, deeply and comfortably. And as those muscles continue to soften and relax while you rest there, that relaxation can begin to spread down the arms to the hands, all the way to the tips of your fingers. And I don't know which arm will relax fully fastest, whether it'll be the left arm or the right arm, or whether the arms will relax at the same rate and speed as each other. And as that relaxation continues through those arms, it can flow down through your stomach, through your sides and lower back, all the way down to your bottom, before extending deeply down through your legs, to the tips of your toes. And as your body becomes deeper and deeper relaxed, while you drift into the most pleasant sleep, so your mind begins to relax. You begin to have a sense of a healing light touching your forehead, enveloping your face and head with healing, deep relaxation, absorbing comfortably and gently into you with each in-breath that you take, filling you with healing peace and calm, spreading that healing, restorative, recuperative light down through your body. Breathing in healing, calm relaxation. And breathing out any stress or tension. Aware of that healing light passing down your neck, softening and relaxing those muscles, spreading that healing light throughout the neck, as it spreads down with the next breath to your shoulders, around the back of your neck and down into your arms, gradually continuing that flow of healing light all the way down to your fingertips. And with another in-breath, the healing light can spread down through the body, softening and relaxing muscles, healing deep within the body, filling the body with pleasure and deep relaxation. As the light journeys down around your stomach, your lower back and sides, into your buttocks and all the way down your legs to the soles of your feet, filling your whole body with that healing, restorative light. And as you allow that light to flow with each breath, you can find your mind drifting deeper and deeper into a reverie. You have that sense of resting in that chair, feeling how supported you are in that chair, how deeply relaxed, with your eyes closed and noticing the faint flickering and dancing of the light through those closed eyelids from the comfortable fire in the fireplace. And you can hear the sound of the rain on the window. And hear the distant storm rolling in gently. And you have this sense, almost like you're opening your eyes and awakening from the reverie, but knowing that you're still deeply within that reverie, and leaving the chair, and beginning to walk over to a window of the cabin that looks out towards the lake. And as you walk away from the chair, you see yourself out of your peripheral vision, resting, sleeping, looking so incredibly peaceful, deeply relaxed. And you silently head to that window. You gaze out into the darkness, and you can see the way the rain strikes the window. Raindrops race down that window, almost like streaks of light racing from where they strike the window all the way down to the base of the window, looking as if they're weaving and dodging obstacles on their path. And you see, as you gaze out over the lake, the dancing, moving, flying light, that you still assume are fireflies, wondering how they are flying in this rain, and the flashes of light beyond the forest as the storm continues to approach. And then you notice some of those lights coming nearer to the cabin. And you watch through the dark window in that gentle glow from within the cabin of the soft lights of the fireplace. And you realize that it's a small fairy. And it comes up near the window and seems to be studying you with as much intensity as you are studying it. And it hovers with its wings almost in a blur, shimmering in the most beautiful light. You watch that beautiful fairy hovering in the window for a while as that fairy watches you back. And you wonder what other magic is out there in this forest, and whether this is still a reverie or perhaps some kind of astral projection, where you've been able to travel outside of your body while you rest there, almost psychically traveling over to the window and looking out of that window. And after a while of gazing out of that window, the fairy flies back off again and seems to carry on whatever it was they were doing. You notice that all those lights look like they're flying around with purpose. So you wonder whether there's just something that they have to do every night, come rain or nice weather. And you feel that sense of being drawn back to your body. And so you head back to your body. You relax back down into your body, deeper and deeper. And then find that your eyes open while you're resting in that chair. You notice how much that fire has burned down now to just the most gentle embers. You go over to the window. And there's some condensation on the window, so you rub that condensation away with your sleeve. You look out of that window and you can see those lights flying around with purpose. You think about your experience and wonder whether it was just a reverie or something more. You sit in the chair for a while longer, reading a good book. Your sleeve gently drying off by the last of the warmth of the fire. That storm still unchanged outside. Some sound of thunder. The sound of the rain on the windows. And in this room, there's a long and comfortable sofa. And so you go and grab a blanket from a cupboard. You head to that sofa. You tuck that blanket over the top of the sofa, hanging it diagonally down, making a sofa tent. Turn off the light. You settle down into your sofa tent. That blanket hanging across the sofa. And this sofa is so incredibly comfortable to relax on. And as you relax on that sofa, you're aware of the sounds around you. And while you're aware of those sounds, you want to begin to comfortably drift asleep. And so you close your eyes and you imagine yourself standing at the top of 20 steps. Looking down over the most beautiful garden. And you begin to descend those steps. Stepping onto step 20, and then 19, and down onto 18 and 17. Becoming deeper and deeper absorbed in the experience with each step. Being more aware of the garden below. Of the flowers in the garden, the insects flying from flower to flower. That bench across the other side of the garden, along a path. The trees around the outside of the garden, the bushes. The songbirds in this garden. As you continue to descend, becoming deeper and deeper absorbed in the experience with each step that you're taking. 16, 15, 14, so slowly and carefully and softly descending those steps deeper and deeper into the most comfortable, relaxing sleep. 13, 12, 11, knowing this strategy works so well for you to help you fall asleep deeply and comfortably, all the way deeper and deeper, noticing the way that you feel deeper absorbed and more relaxed in the experience with each step that you take. As you step onto step 10, 9, 8, slowly deeper and deeper absorbed in the experience. 7, 6, 5, being even more aware of this garden that you're walking into, perhaps noticing the smells in this garden, relaxing so peacefully and comfortably as you step onto step 4, 3, 2, and then stepping off of the bottom step, 1, where you find yourself walking comfortably along a path towards that bench. And as you walk comfortably to that bench and arrive at that bench and settle down on that bench in the most comfortable way that you can, you feel a deep sense of peace and calm. Aware that relaxing on this bench in this garden is bringing deep comfort, relaxation and stillness to your mind and body as you transition towards the most beautiful lucid dreaming sleep. And then through the various stages of sleep, knowing you'll get the perfect night's sleep, the perfect combination of dreaming, sleep, and deep recuperative sleep. And then as you pass into that deep recuperative sleep, it's almost like you're relaxing back on that bench in this place, closing your eyes, drifting, floating, relaxing deeper and deeper into the most incredible peace and calm of sleep now. And as you continue to sleep, now the garden fades away, the bench fades away, the experience of all that fades away, and you notice the sounds in the distance around you of that rain on the window in the cabin, the storm beyond those windows, beyond the forest. Feeling so deeply relaxed and deeper asleep with those sounds in the background, finding that they help you to be absorbed in your experience of sleeping soundly through the night in the most appropriate and comfortable way. And drifting and floating so easily and effortlessly, honestly and fully, drifting asleep. Finding yourself drifting deeper and deeper asleep, drifting and floating, deeply relaxed, asleep into slumberland.